When we go to museums and admire all those beautiful painting collections that they have, what we see is only the surface layer of the painting. But have you ever wondered what lies underneath? In this video, we will first explore the different layers of the painting, and then we will start looking at what kind of scientific methods can be used to study the different layers of the paintings. Hi, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, I'm Maria, and I make videos related to cultural heritage and heritage science. We've seen in previous videos how different scientific methods can be used to study different objects of cultural heritage, including paintings. Today, we will learn about the structure of a painting, and we will see exactly which scientific methods can be used to access which layer of a painting. So let's get right into it. First, every painting needs to have a support, a base on which the painting is built. There are several different types of materials that can be used for the support. This includes softer materials like canvas, paper, and leather. But we can also use harder materials for support, and this can be wood, metal, or glass. Here, we'll focus more on paintings done on canvas. On top of the support, there is a layer of glue. There are different uses of glue in the painting structure. Glue can be used in the lining of the painting, where conservators used to add animal glue to a canvas and then add another canvas on top of it for consolidation. Glue can also be used to add the ground layer. This layer is added for different purposes. For example, in oil paintings, it is added to protect the support from the oil diffusing into the support materials. Or it can be used to provide a consistent application to the paint layer, or it can even create certain artistic effects. The ground could have chalk or acrylic polymer emulsion as the basic component. On top of the ground, the artist creates the sketch. Different carbon-rich materials can be used for creating the sketch. These include charcoal, graphite, or bone black. The sketch is then covered by imprimitura. This is a thin preliminary glaze added to the painting to prime it before adding the paint layers. These contain all those beautifully colored paints that we admire when we observe paintings. These paints consist of powder pigment mixed with a binder of some sort. Depending on whether it's an acrylic painting, an oil painting, or watercolor, artists use the binder that works best in their painting medium, and these can be oils, synthetic binders, or gum arabic. Finally, a layer of varnish is applied on top of the painting. The varnish has different purposes. It can be used as a protective layer of the painting, shielding the paint layers from dirt and dust. Additionally, a glossy varnish is also helpful in enhancing the colors of the painting. It is important to note that while this is the general structure of a painting, and all these are possible layers in a painting structure, that doesn't mean that every painting consists of every single one of these elements. They can vary from painting to painting depending on the artist's technique and the medium and materials they use for their artistic expression. Now that we've explored together the different painting layers, let's see which kind of scientific methods we can use to study each of these layers. X-rays can penetrate all the layers of the painting. Two non-invasive uses of X-rays in studying paintings are X-radiography and X-ray fluorescence. X-radiography can reveal the different elements of a painting from canvas all the way to the top paint layer. XRF, a method that we've discussed in detail and I'll link it in the top right corner, can reveal the elemental composition of the paint layers and thus reveal the types of pigments that were used by the artist. The sketch layer can be accessed and beautifully imaged by infrared reflectography. When it comes to the paint layers, there are many non-invasive scientific techniques that we can use. Some of them, which I will link in the top right corner, include X-ray fluorescence and infrared and Raman spectroscopy for studying the chemical composition. Mobile NMR can be used to study the stratigraphy of the paintings and the aging of the paint layers. And the aging of the oil component and that of the varnish can be examined under ultraviolet light. Now that we've learned about all these different layers of a painting and the different scientific methods that we can use to access each of these layers, if you could analyze any oil painting in the world, which one would you choose and what would you like to find out about it? And if you want to learn even more about the painting structure, I will link down in the video description the papers that detail all the different points that I talked about today. I hope you enjoyed learning about the painting structure and the scientific methods that we can use to examine all of these different layers of a painting, even the deeper layers, not just the surface pigment layers. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the bell button to receive notifications when I upload fun videos from the world of cultural heritage and heritage science. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!